Hello and thank you for joining me here again at St. Jane Francis de Chantal Parish at the heart of Bethesda. This weekend, Father's Day weekend, after many weeks, we will resume the public celebration of Mass here at church. And we will do so following our usual weekend schedule of Masses, beginning with Saturday afternoon at 5 p.m. and Sunday morning at 8 a.m., 10 a.m., 12 noon, and then finally Sunday afternoon at 5 p.m. Of course, things are going to be a bit different for a while, so I'd like to go over some of the changes you may encounter. But first, let me assure you that Archbishop Gregory's dispensation from attending Sunday Mass remains in effect. This is important to remember. If you are not feeling well, or if you believe that you've been exposed to someone who has tested positive for the COVID virus, or if you are in a high-risk group, you will want to refrain from coming to Mass, at least for the time being. We will continue to live stream our Sunday Mass at 10 a.m., and that's available to you through our parish website. If you do come to Mass this weekend, you will notice that the church has been prepared to meet the social distancing requirements of the county and the archdiocese. About half the pews have been restricted from access by white ribbons, and appropriate spacing in the open pews has been designated by white stickers. Now, family members who have been confined together the last few weeks may share a pew. The distancing measures have reduced the usual capacity we enjoy here in our church. It is my hope, however, not to keep anyone from attending Mass who comes and who would like to do so, even with fewer places available. If it appears that more people have come to Mass than the reduced capacity can accommodate, we will offer an additional Mass at the same time in a second location, an overflow Mass, so to speak, which will be held in either Caulfield Hall or Christopher Hall, which is known as the school gym. Both of those locations are already prepared for Mass and will be ready to go if necessary. You may be invited, if the situation requires, to go to one of those other locations if the church is nearing its capacity. If you do come to Mass, you will need to wear a mask during the service. There are hand sanitizing locations set up in the narthex of the church and in other areas near the entrance. We ask that you make use of them as you come into the church. Other temporary changes you will notice will be to the music program. We will not have the opening and closing hymns we usually do, and there will be more instrumental music for Mass instead. Baskets will not be passed for the offertory collection. Instead, you'll be able to make your offering in baskets placed around the perimeter of the church. There will be no offertory procession with the gifts either. The sign of peace will be omitted until further notice, and only hosts will be distributed for Holy Communion. One of the things that you may not see, but which will take place after every Mass, is that the church will receive a cleaning of surfaces with disinfectant. Now, earlier this week, Father Luckett asked me if I was all prepared to celebrate the 12th Sunday of Ordinary Time. And I told him that at this point in time, I'm ready to celebrate anything that's ordinary. It would be nice to come back to church and have everything just as we left it in March. However, all of the steps and changes are being undertaken to minimize the risks to everyone's health, and I'm sure you understand. What is important to remember is what we will have as Mass resumes: our faith in God, the encouragement we have from one another, inspiration from the Holy Spirit, God's word to us in sacred scripture, and the divine presence of Jesus Christ in Holy Communion. I look forward to seeing you again, and may God bless you for your extraordinary faithfulness during this extraordinary time.